So joining us now on the phone is newly promoted assistant GM of the St. Louis Blues, Bill Armstrong. First of all, Bill, thank you for joining us. Congratulations on the promotion. But let's just start with what we heard from Robby Fabbri. It sounds like a guy who's been really raring to go now for, what do you say, 20 months getting ready for this season. Do you expect him to be 100% at the start of the season? And if so, what does that do for your club?
Well, he's a big part of our club. I mean, he's an energy player that can score. And he's a big game player in big moments. Ever since he's played junior all the way up, watching him play for the Marlies, against the Marlies. And when I was a kid, he was just tremendous. And he's certainly somebody that we met. Coming back 100%, I think it'll take him a little bit of time to get through it and work his way through it. But for the most part, he's really been training. I got to watch him the other day at the BioSteel camp. And he looked right back where he left off. And so that's good news for us. And he'll come into training camp healthy and in shape.
Bill, congrats on the new job. That's a nice promotion. But how does your job is going to evolve now from director of scouting to the job of assistant GM?
Well, that's interesting. There's only so many hours in the day. My job for the most part will be to oversee the amateur staff and keep that growing and keep the talent coming into St. Louis. During the summer this year, I've spent a lot more time being on the road, going to the summer tournaments, trying to get farther ahead so I could spend a little bit more time watching our team and watching the prospects in San Antonio. And, it's a challenge because, like I said, there's only so many hours in the day, but I'm looking forward to it. And I think through the summer hockey that's played now, not only in Europe, but also over here in North America, you can catch up a lot by putting some hours in the summer. It can free up some time in the winter to watch your big club and along with your minor league club.
Well, Bill, I know a lot of people around the network here are buzzing about the St. Louis Blues. There's a lot of optimism there because you've gotten some really nice pieces added to the mix. Let's start with Ryan O'Reilly. What do you expect him to bring to the ice?
Well, leadership. He's hungry to win. The one thing that we love about him is, Doug Armstrong's had some experiences with him with Team Canada. Just raved about him as a person and as a player. He also fits in that center slot, and centers are very hard to find at the National Hockey League level. They're an extinct species almost, and he's somebody that can distribute the puck, and along with that, he's probably one of the best faceoff men in the game. So there's a lot of little details he adds to his game, but he certainly fits for us in the middle of the ice and just brings a ton of leadership and a ton of other things that, you can't put a value on.
Bill, there's one top prospect that the Blues have that you've probably seen play more than most is Robert Thomas. Can you fill us, our viewers, about his game and his potential?
Yeah, he's a special prospect for us. Just in the sense, again, he's a centerman. He's someone that plays very, very quick. He thinks the game at a very, very high level. For a young prospect, this player has already won a Memorial Cup. And he was a huge piece of Team Canada winning a World Juniors. He led his team to the Memorial Cup last year in Hamilton. Fell a little bit short, but he's a special player. And as I said before, the centermen are very, very hard to find. And he's a unique one. He's very quick in the mind and in the leg. He does all the little details of the game, and he can affect the game so many ways. And for us, he's going to get a good look at camp. He's had some being injured in the summer, so hopefully that's all healed up and he's ready to go.
You're obviously very well versed in your farm system and of course, at younger levels of hockey. So, what did you think of this year's draft and the way St. Louis came out of it?
Oh, it was an interesting draft. A lot of things were floating around the table with trades. a lot of things. Your GM is whispering in your ear, "What about this? What about this?" And then, he turns and says, "Hey, listen, we're going to take the pick." And we felt with the kid that we got, the German player that plays over in Sweden, Dominic Bach, we didn't think we were going to get him. And we didn't want to wait in the slot we were picking, so we traded up to get him. And I think if we didn't do that, somebody else would have taken him. He's a special player. He plays the game at a high level, and he thinks the game very, very fast. Tremendous playmaker with a little bit of a scoring touch. He's a unique player. He was in our prospect camp in the summer and really showed some great flashes of one-on-one skill and ability to score and make plays. So he's actually going to come to Traverse City for us in rookie camp and spend some time over here, which is great, so he can kind of adjust to the North American style play, but it'll be a great experience for him, and we're looking forward to seeing him.
We're looking forward to the new season. We count down every day. We're getting so close. So thanks so much for the time, Bill. Enjoy the few weeks that you have left before the full weight of the new job kicks in.
All right. Thanks, Jimmy. Thanks, Alex, for having me on.